Good morning, guys. Thanks for listening to Coffee with Christ. If you haven't subscribed, hit the button below. Like this video, share it with your friends. It's sweater weather. It was cold out this morning. I love that. You know, I love that for like a half a second just because I get to wear the sweaters, but then I'm not really a cold weather person. I'm like, I love the warm weather, but I like the change of seasons because I like clothing and I can change it. And so I want to talk this morning about time. So my love language is time. And so the concept of spending time with the Lord is really not that hard for me because that's how I receive love. How many of you know that how you receive love is a lot of times how you try to give love? So this concept is not something that I struggle with a whole bunch, but it is something a lot of people struggle with. And so the whole vision of Coffee with Christ is just about no rules, just spending time with Jesus and maybe doing it over a cup of coffee, which you have all that, you know, you are drinking anyway. You know, time with your Savior Jesus, time with your friend Jesus. That's what Coffee with Christ is all about. And so if you want to know the heart of Father God, you've got to spend some time with him. You've got to take time and sit with Jesus. You've got to take time and read his word. Now, these are things that we hear a lot, right? And so do you ever remember, like in elementary school, anybody else? Like, so when you liked a boy or girl, you never went and told the boy or girl, maybe you sent a note, but you would go tell your friend and you would have your friend tell the boy or girl. So this morning, I feel like the friend. I feel like the Lord has laid it on my heart this morning with such urgency that he likes you. He wants to spend time with you. He wants to meet with you. So if you're listening to this, the Lord wants to meet with you because I'm that friend and he's laying and beckoning me to tell you that. He wants to speak to you and reveal things to you in your secret place. He needs your time. That is what I'm supposed to bring today. He needs your time. And I say that with urgency and love because that's how it was laid on my heart. And that's how I was impressed to tell you with urgency and love that he needs your time. He wants to reveal things to you and he needs that. And so some of us have gotten really, really good about doing things. We've gotten really good about doing things within the church, serving people, doing our job well. We've gotten really good about raising our families and being busy about that. But I'm here to remind you that all of those things, he wanted me to remind you of the story of Mary and Martha. And so Luke 10, 38 through 42 is the story of Mary and Martha. I'm going to read it really quickly and just leave you with that. And know that the Lord is adamant. He loves you so much. So the story of Mary and Martha says, as Jesus and the disciples continued on their way to Jerusalem, they came to a certain village where a woman named Martha welcomed him into her home. Her sister Mary sat at the Lord's feet listening to what he taught. But Martha was distracted by the big dinner she was preparing. She came to Jesus and said, Lord, doesn't it seem unfair to you that my sister just sits here while I do all the work? Tell her to come and help me. But the Lord said to her, my dear Martha, you are worried and upset over all these details. Does that feel like anyone else? Hello, we've all been there. There is only one thing worth being concerned about. Mary has discovered it and it will not be taken away from her. What did Mary discover? She sat at the feet of Jesus and listened to him teach. The Lord is just imploring, he loves you and he wants you to be like Mary. He wants you to be like Mary. So I want you to have a great day. I'm praying for you and I will talk to you tomorrow.